Welcome, my name is Andreas Dreger and you are watching the Systems Biology channel. In the previous video, we embedded a manually created metabolic map of the central carbon metabolism of Baker's yeast in the SBML file IMM904. Next, we prepared a character-separated value file from the time course dataset that Bergdahl et al. Published in 2012. We can now visually analyze a model that comes with embedded layout information and explore a real dataset from laboratory experiments in the context of this model. Let's load this new model into SBML simulator. We now see a warning that many model components lack initial values. This only matters when running a dynamic simulation, since we plan to use SBML simulator to create an animation of experimental data. We don't need to run a simulation and can safely ignore this warning. The graph tab now shows us the same neat display that we already saw on the Big Models website. Now let's find out how to create a dynamically animated network of yeast. When we now drop our time series data file into SBML simulator, it displays an import dialog asking us to confirm the matching of data columns to model components. Since we prepared everything already, there's nothing left to do. In case our model identifiers do not precisely match those in the CSV file, we have here the option to adjust the mapping. Let's switch off the status bar and controls in the View menu, because we don't need them anymore. The tab for experimental data is now enabled, where we can see the same table that we had prepared. The graph tab has automatically loaded the dataset and mapped the values to the nodes. We can select our favorite visualization of the data, available on node sizes or colors in absolute values or relative to minimum and maximum in the dataset. My personal favorite is displaying the relative fill level in combination with absolute color values. This checkbox allows us to create a repeated animation, and we can pan and zoom while it is running, and we can change the visualization style. We can customize the color scheme and other visual attributes, such as minimal and maximal node sizes, in the settings dialog. We can zoom in and use the slider at the bottom to move to time points during the animation that we are most interested in. By clicking this icon, we can create an image file of the current state of the graph in the vector file format SVG or in PNG format that we can save to a file. This drop-down list allows us to adjust the speed of the animation in three different levels: normal, fast, or slow. When we click this button, we see a diagram of all variables within our dataset, and a red vertical bar indicating the current position moving in sync with our animation. This view allows us to compare different visual representations and to directly observe the most active spots in our network. If we want to display the exact values of metabolite concentrations and so forth, we just need to check the boxes to the right. Since we can adjust all of this while the animation is still ongoing, this really is a seamless animation. Another exciting feature is the sliding camera animation that we can activate by selecting a speed from this drop-down box. To design such an animation, we need to create a CSV file that contains, in one line, the zoom level followed by a tab-separated list of corner points. These are the X and Y coordinates of the top left corners that define the path of the visible sliding viewport window. In other words, these coordinates define where the camera makes a turn on its way. Here we can see an example of such a file for the animation you just saw. To enable the camera animation, we go to the settings and navigate to the bottom of the tab Network Dynamics. Finally, we can export the animation that we just created to a movie file. This gives us first a warning because of the high resolution, so the export may take some time and consume some space on our hard drive. The export supports a wide range of common movie file types, including AVI, MOVE, MP4 and others. In this video, we visualized manually created layouts of experimental data. If you enjoyed watching this video, check out our other videos within our YouTube channel on Systems Biology that explore other fascinating examples of dynamic metabolic networks. I hope this video was interesting and helps you with analyzing your datasets. Thank you for watching and thanks to all people who helped prepare this series of tutorial videos. Thanks for watching the Systems Biology channel.